thanks Business World for inviting us to present in this forum. Now I'm going to talk about, so the organization that I represent here is QuessCorp Limited, and I head the business called Q Infra, or the Quest Infra division of the QuessCorp. So first, talking about what is Quest. So in that perspective, to make it short, what I would say is, while there is this dream about smart cities, we have a lot of eminent people who have been strategizing about smart cities. We have great knowledgeable consultants who are designing the smart cities. Where we come is about executing the projects and bringing those dreams into reality. So my presentation would be in three parts. First part is we will play a video which talks about QuessCorp. Second, I'll have a very short presentation specific talking about the infra. And third part is the most interesting part. Third part is we were partners with Trimax in implementing the Ahmedabad Smart City. So please roam around the city, look at what has been implemented, and that's my third part of the presentation. So I'm not going to hold you in this room for the third part. Now I'll just specifically talk about related to this Conclave, the business that I'm into it, and that's the infra segment. Can you put on the presentation, please? So before that, I will also put some specific, when the video talked about the group and its growth, we'll talk some specific numbers so that it says what have we done in last 10 years. So first, I think that video was 4 months back. So today we are more than 2,43,000 people. In fact, we would be the second largest private employer in India, largest, the Tata Group company. Today we are a $2.5 billion market cap with last year reported revenues, which are around $668 million. We have consistently shown more than 40% CAGR growth in last 5 years. Across 9 countries, more than 1,700 clients. Again, so that video was around October. After that, we had few more acquisitions. Today, in last 6 years, we have completed more than 22 acquisitions. Latest being the acquisition of Tata Business Services Solutions, which was a Tata Group company, purely into customer lifecycle management, so that kind of work. And Monster, India and Asia Pacific. So these are the two latest acquisitions. And this is how, as group, we stack up in terms of 4 different verticals and all the different brands. Now coming to our reach, when we talk about India, we are, the best way to talk about is, talk to my finance team, he will say I have GST registration across 28 states. So that only there is one state that's missing. So 28 states that we have reached to. Across that, we are talking about 65 corporate offices, but operational offices would be more. Like all the Northeast states I would cover in my operational offices. In terms of capabilities across different 4 different verticals, obviously it talks about a variety of things that we bring into table, but key things that I would talk which will be relevant to this forum is, yes, we do smart city turnkey projects, and the example is the Ahmedabad Smart City. Smart transportation turnkey projects, telecom infra and turnkey projects, I will talk about it more in one of the subsequent slides. Customized data center solutions, IT infra networking solutions, which again I will discuss more in subsequent slide. One of the key things is about digital surveillance. We talked about a lot in the morning. The commissioner sir also spoke about the digital surveillance and how important it is now for safe and secured environment the government can present for the citizens. So we'll talk about that, and that's, we have a unique solution in that. And we are one of the largest partners of government particularly under Ministry of Skill Development on the entrepreneurship, we actually have more than 66 skill development centers in India across the length and breadth of the country. We have more than 22 Pradhan Mantri Kausal Kendra, where in last year only we actually skilled more than 22,000 people. In the, like, you can talk about the places where today which are known as the red corridors. So even there also we have trained people and put them into industry. So now talking about smart infra, and I think this is what you will be seeing in the second half when you go to the ICC. So that's the command and control center. We're talking about the smart traffic solution that we have put across ANPR, RLVD, that kind of thing. This is again you would have seen on the riverfront, the whole the VMD, and one of the things Mukesh Kumarji mentioned in the morning is about the whole revenue generation model that can be developed out of this. And then obviously many more components of the smart city, whether it's public Wi-Fi, smart lighting, adaptive traffic management, smart parking, environment sensors. So that's the execution capability that we bring in. And it goes back to one of the, the corporate focus, the corporate culture and the focus areas that we talked about. Execution and speed and agility. That's what we stand for and that's what we deliver as part of our projects. Now coming to the telecom active infra. In fact, between two of our brands, that is Maxit and Vedang, we would be the largest player in India in terms of active infra management, which actually talks about, so we work mostly with the large telcos here. So we are involved in network planning, network design, network implementation, and the cluster optimization part, and which obviously includes the whole spectrum of activities involved in that. So we work for three of the largest telcos in India. And apart from active, we are also big in the passive part of it. In fact, we were one of the significant partners for the recent the telecom capacity addition that happened for one of the largest business houses. You know who I'm talking about. We were working in the 26 circles for them. We are also right now foraying into the OFC projects. We are active mostly now in the northeastern states, where, and obviously that's a difficult terrain, but that's where we are working for the a large OFC project. Now, as I said, a technology division I talked about, we are talking about the network management, the IT asset management. The best part of it is the customized data center solutions. And in fact, we own two data centers based out of North America, because one of our arms called MFX, which actually through that we provide cloud-based platform for insurance policy and claims processing. And last year, more than $3.2 billion worth of claims were processed through that system. So we own not only, provide that solution for the customers, but we own our own data center. Now that's one thing that I was talking about, is our unique solution offering, particularly in safety and security aspect, and that's what I call Terrier Care proposition, and that Terrier is one of the brands that we own, where we are talking about CARE stands for capture, analyze, respond and engage. Capture is through different sensors, devices, and capturing an activity that is happening. We have, again, our own IoT analytical platforms through which I try to gauge a sense about what is this activity and is this activity is liable to trigger a alarm. And once that alarm is triggered, then an appropriate response is again generated by the command and control center. And since we have large man guarding workforce, so there is one is through the workforce, man guarding workforce and engagement, or through the emergency response team, so on and so forth. And obviously, how do we operate? We specifically operate in three different verticals, and that's not talking about the infra business, the urban infra, the telecom, and the transportation. How do we operate? We operate as a master systems integrator, and based on these following tenets, that one is collaboration. Obviously, you know, this kind of large projects talks about collaboration with various partners, with various players in the industry. Execution, that's our core. Philosophy for us is execution, execution, execution. That's our core, and that's what we stand for. And innovation. Obviously, we are talking about smart cities, the whole digital infra, and the kind of innovation that we talked about in the morning by agitators about waste. Similarly, what we becomes is the agent of intervention of innovation into the system. So there are small IoT innovations that are happening. We become agent of getting those innovations into the system. And then we operate under this brand called, for infra, called Q Infra Solutions.